you make of the ruling visit?
Yes, we are very happy as Hustler Nation. Personally, I'm vindicated. I had personally warned the president that this process would fail, but they didn't listen to me. I was kicked out, and it is coming to pass. I wish I was heard then. Definitely will not be here now. When you look at the judgment, several grounds have been cited by the court as to why BBI should die. You would find them, they would agree together in some, they would disagree in others. But the singular issue they agreed on was that there is no way the president could have used popular initiative to initiate constitutional amendment. That is Article 257 of the Constitution. That was the bottom line of what I was telling him in my letter. Because in my letter, what I have done was to tell him that the people are not feeling BBI. It appears to be driven by the provincial administration. It is not participatory and inclusive, the way what you call a popular initiative usually is. But there was a lot of chest dumping. There was a lot of intimidation. You know, so many people were being arrested for saying a view that is contrary to the government position. Now see where we are. BBI, the government spends billions of shillings to push BBI. If definitely I was heard in January, we would not be here. They seem to have become independent, courageous, and we are it not for the courts. Definitely our 2010 constitution would have been mutilated. The second lesson Kenyan should learn is a constitutional review process is something that needs to be participatory. You should not weaponize it for politics. Remember, there was a time I saw Raila Odinga telling Ruto that you should remain no, we want to use this process to finish you. I recall even some parliamentarians, when they were voting in parliament on BBI, they would announce that Tanga Tanga is dead now. To me, that's a problem. Yes. You don't expect a 100% convergence of views on matters constitution, but the process has to be inclusive to the best of our knowledge. Finally, another lesson is that we need to focus on economy. We look at our poor people, joblessness, we look at our collapse in healthcare, we need to look at our collapse in agriculture sector. Constitutional making process or review is not a priority for Kenyans. Kenyans wants to have food on their table. Kenyans wants to have a peaceful election. We strongly believe the Constitution of Kenya 2010 is a good document. It has helped Kenyans, have been progressive. Remember, it is on that basis, for instance, in 2017, an election of a president was overturned. So effort to overturn or to mutilate that constitution were not good at all.
Mheshimiwa, are we seeing, is this the last of efforts to amend the constitution in any way, or will be seeing discussions with a different approach as opposed to this that has rested?
I can't really tell. You know, it depends on how the actors want to proceed. I would personally urge some of the good things that you see contain that document can easily be passed in parliament. Take for instance, increasing money to the counties. You don't need a constitutional amendment to achieve that. I had brought County Ward Development Fund Bill, that was intended to send money to the wards. It was passed by Senate. It was killed by the National Assembly. Why can't the National Assembly pass my bill? You do not need a constitutional amendment to ensure money is sent to the ward level. What about the idea of increasing monies to the counties? Again, you don't need a constitutional amendment because the constitution talks of a floor, what we call the 15%. It doesn't indicate or set a ceiling. So meaning the president through a policy paper can definitely increase monies that goes to the counties without necessarily taking us to a referendum. So for me, we want to celebrate the courts. Today is a historic day. Personally, at a personal level, I feel vindicated. If I was listened way back in January, we'll definitely.